Hi, I'm Adrian Richardson, and I'm going to share with you one of my favourite dishes to cook on a barbecue. It's called a kofta. It's a Middle Eastern sausage without the skin, and it is really easy to make. You start with a kilo of lean lamb mince, which is in my bowl here, and to that I'll add some red onion that's been finely chopped. Just about half an onion is all you need. I'll also add some allspice. Now, allspice is quite strong, so you just need a pinch. Some chili. I love chili because it gives it even more spice. About a teaspoon of that is perfect. I'm going to use some ground ginger, but of course you can use fresh if you like. Now, ground ginger is quite strong, so I'll only use about half a teaspoon. And two cloves of garlic. Cumin is a great spice, and you use it a lot in Middle Eastern cooking. I'm using about half a teaspoon of whole cumin seeds. Of course, if you've got ground, you can use that as well. And fennel is another one of my favorites. I use about a teaspoon of whole fennel seed, and of course, ground is just as good. Now, I love fresh herbs, so I've got some finely chopped parsley in there as well, and coriander. They give it a great flavor. If you don't like coriander, just take it out. Now we need some pepper, a good twist of black pepper, and that'll make it even tastier. Now salt loves meat, and meat loves salt, and my koftas love salt. It's the salt that brings out the flavor, so make sure you put plenty of that in there. Now I want a bit of extra spice, so I will add some fresh chili and pop it into the kofta. Now here's the fun bit. Just mix it around gently and make sure those ingredients are spread evenly through the kofta mix. Now to make the koftas, grab a nice amount of kofta mix, about a size of a rissole or a hamburger, and then you pop it onto your board and roll it like a sausage. You'll find it's quite sticky, and that's a good thing. That means that the kofta will hold together. And then very, very easily, you grab your skewer and then push it down the center of the kofta. The skewer will hold it together and make it a lot easier to move around. Have a look at that. You can see all these great ingredients in there, and it smells fantastic. When you're ready to cook the kofta, just put your Ziggy barbecue onto a high temperature. And we've got a little temperature gauge here that tells me when it's ready to cook. Now this Ziggy barbecue has a signature flamethrower ignition, which lights first time, every time. And on windy days, it will light burners that blow out, so you can feel safe about cooking on this barbecue. Now I recommend using the triple grill hot plate, which holds its heat beautifully and will cook these koftas to perfection. I can't wait to be tucking into these. Not long to go. Now the warming rack is a great tool to use if you want to hold some food to wait for people to get out of the pool. It'll hold it beautifully. Have a look at that. Now the koftas are ready to go, and I'll grab my plate here and just take them off the top here. They smell fantastic. They've got great caramelization on the outside, and I know they are cooked to perfection. Now I've got some lemon here, and I'll slice this through the middle and squeeze it over the top. Nothing better than a little bit of lemon on top of the kofta to give it some zing. And then just a little sprinkle of coriander to make it look nice and fluffy. Now here's how you put the whole thing together. You grab some pita bread like this, some lubna, which is just yogurt that's been dried out a little bit, and we've also got some hummus as well. A little spoon of that, spread that out onto your bread, and then grab the kofta. It'll be red hot, but I'm just dying to get into it. A little bit more coriander on the top here. Now here's Richo's pro tip. Please make sure you take the skewer out. It's very, very chewy. Now all you need to do is take a nice little bite out of it. That is great.